This is News Life.
The manufacturing sector is pushing for the creation of more economic zones in the country. This to help create more jobs for the people. This report.
Manufacturing posted a 9% growth for the third quarter of 2013, a trend that is expected to be sustained in the years to come due to solid gains of the economy under President Aquino's leadership.
The past 3 years by now, 2010, 2011, 2011, 2012, and now 2013, has been a remarkable 3 years for us, especially in terms of macroeconomic stability and rapid growth. And I think everybody in this room would recognize that manufacturing has gone a long way from being an industry that is no longer competitive or thought to be uncompetitive to what it is today. In Q3, manufacturing grew by 9.7% based on GDP numbers. The prior quarter, it grew by 10.3%, and the prior quarter, it grew by 9.7%. So it's quite on the road.
Manufacturing generates high-quality jobs and better incomes because of the gains in this sector. Local and foreign businessmen have banded together to push for the creation of 4 million jobs in less than a decade. They presented a two-track strategy which calls for the establishment of new economic zones, relaxing labor laws and more training to enhance the quality of labor needed for manufacturing. Today, there are 3.5 million employed in manufacturing, which accounts for 21% of the economy. The goal is to increase its impact to growth. More eco zones are being pushed in the countryside. So with the retention of fiscal incentives, addressing the cost of power, reducing red tape which breeds corruption, lifting the restrictions on land ownership.
Red tape and over-regulation outside the peasant zones, and I would say it's also occurring inside peasant zones. Another example would be double requirements. When you have one government agency and another government agency asking for the same exact electrical and mechanical permit, and they don't seem to be talking to each other, asking for the same permit.
Manufacturing can be low cost, labor intensive. Products produced in this sector for export are furniture and garments. Tariff has hindered the export of garments. High value manufacturing is a major export dollar earner. Semiconductors and computers are among the products which account for 70% of the country's exports. There is consensus in the private sector that this is the perfect time to attract more foreign direct investments, since many companies from China are relocating to other countries due to rising costs of labor and even power. The improving competitiveness of the Philippines is also a major plus.
China, according to an ADB study, a few months ago, is predicted to lose 50% of the 85 to 100 million manufacturing jobs in China because of rising costs or shift to machinery and higher tech production methods. Third, the rising labor costs that we see in the competing economies for labor-intensive manufacturing, which include Vietnam, Indonesia, where the minimum labor in Jakarta is actually higher than it is in MCR now. China, of course, we're all well aware of that.
For the People's Television Network, this is Freddie Abanda reporting.
This is News Life.